Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and I had a CO2 laser treatment. Now, it was 3 weeks ago, so this is what I look like 3 weeks after the treatment. 1 week after the treatment, I was walking along the showroom floor, or the exhibit hall, I guess you would say, at the AMWC conference in Medellin, 1 week after I received my CO2 treatment. So in this video, I'm going to show you that video I made there. It's a short clip. I go over the laser. You can look at my face. I also give you close-up pictures that were taken at around 2 to 4 days after the laser. You can see what I look like. You can see the downtime, the brown spots. Now, CO2 laser, many of my patients really like it. There is some downtime. It targets browns, fine lines. It's supposed to give you a nice glow. I must say I'm very happy with it. I had a little more downtime than maybe I thought. The traditional CO2s, you have a lot of downtime. Then we went to fractionated CO2s and now a lighter fractionated CO2. What fractionated means is that we're treating a portion of the skin and we're leaving another portion untreated to help reduce the healing time. So definitely it has become more palatable, more feasible to get these treatments because the downtime isn't what it once was. You need several now to get the results of what one was before. I am of the age and stage where I did do full ablative of CO2 and then transitioned to fractional CO2 around 2007 and now the lighter fractional CO2. A note before we get into this video, skin care and taking care of the surface of the skin is so important if you want to maintain beautiful and healthy, vibrant skin. It works with your skincare, with your fillers, with your biostimulators. It's not one or the other. And one of the most difficult things in my clinic of convincing my patients to do is just that. Devices to keep the skin surface smooth, to keep the surface collagen producing, and to give that vibrance and the glow to the skin. Kind of wake it up for elastin and collagen. Traditional hyaluronic acid fillers don't do that to a great extent. Biostimulators do, but think of the surface of the skin, the outside of the skin, as the blanket or the tablecloth on the table. The pillars are your fillers and your biostimulators like Sculptra, like Belafil, like calcium hydroxylapatite. Without that surface, that nice surface on the skin, you do have structure and you do have angles, but you need to use more makeup. And why not wake up and not makeup? And for men, a lot of times we don't use makeup, of course, so having a nice surface of the skin is important. So please don't discount that you have to take care of the surface of the skin. It's not as an immediate effect. Of course, as fillers and Botox, you can see I'm just looking reasonable now. I mean, to look reasonable at about a week, you'll see in the video here, but I'm just starting to get the benefits I feel from the laser now to where the skin has a bit of glow and it's smoother. So it's not that quick hit. Let's pop in to Medellin, Colombia and watch the video I made there. I'm Dr. Rajani. I'm here at the AMWC in Medellin, Colombia, and guess what I found? A CO2 laser, the same CO2 that I had on my face 1 week ago. So you can see, looks reasonable today. I'm out, I gave a talk today. A little bit of redness, a few brown spots, but looking pretty reasonable. This is a Decatetra CO2 laser, and it targets 10,600 nanometers. This is a real laser. It targets water. It's an ablative laser. So what I'm noticing is the brown spots fell onto the floor, fine lines and wrinkles are gone, and you get a glow. Now I had the Cool Peel, which is a lighter laser, a lighter setting of the laser, which is specific to this one. And you don't get as much downtime. It's much more palatable. Why I wanted to show you this here in Colombia, there's a lot of skin type 4 and 5. A lot of people said, hey, Dr. Rajani, you're willing to take the risk of having a CO2 laser on my skin? Yes, every procedure we do has a risk. Am I willing to take that for the skin glow and the benefits of CO2? Absolutely. But yes, there are risks. The risk of hypopigmentation, hyperpigmentation, where you get more pigment showing, the risks of not healing, infection. However, to look great, you have to take some risk. Everything you do in aesthetics, there is a risk involved. But with the new lasers, specifically the new CO2s, you get great results, low risks, and nice side effect profile. So you see, this is 1 week, this is what I look like. This is a Tetra CO2 fractionated CO2 laser with the cool peel. It's what I had, and I walked across this booth here in Medellin to show you that all or many skin types can be treated. It's about who's using the laser, the settings, and the experience of the provider. So skincare treatments, whether it's fractionated RF, radio frequency, high frequency ultrasound, other lasers such as erbium YAG or this CO2 are very important in this whole process with your fillers, with your biostimulators, and with topical skincare and rollers. I put a complete playlist up here, things you can do at home, keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.